All in the middle to put them under pressure most of the time. I thought Max come very well in the first half with a lot of pressure. From that point of view, they stood up well. You know, bar the couple of scores just before half time for Armagh, it was probably an even game. It was a poor first half, I'd have to say, football wise, and probably poor from the spectators' point of view, but you know, that's the way it was. Conditions probably were difficult enough as well, those heavy teams of rain. Second half, we still didn't kick on. We had a little bit of a patch, maybe 5-6 minutes in the second half, and we had some opportunities and we shot a few bad wides. And when we needed scores, we didn't need to kick the ball wide, but those things happen to us, and again, it's championship pressure.
To score only a couple of points in the first half must have been disappointing, Terry. And they had about 11 wides, showed that they were creating chances that mightn't be taking them. When you went in at half time, you must have talked to the team about how this could be resurrected in the second half.
Well, as you can see from standing out here, there's actually quite a strong breeze blowing down the field, and that, you know, dictated a lot of the first half. And again, from that point of view, we probably maybe sat back when we did have possession, didn't push forward. It probably was the middle sector of the field where we didn't win enough ball to put their backs under enough pressure in the first half to get those opportunities to get scores on. We had a good gold opportunity just before half time. If we had got it, we were probably well in the game.
There are half forwards and the wing half forwards there, McVeary and Caelan Rafferty. They were running at you and causing all sorts of problems, and they had great capacity to set up attacks and maybe take shots from out the field, maybe in the second half, and try and outweigh the blanket defence.
Well, that's true, I suppose, yeah. You know what I mean? They did all right, and you know, you have to credit Armagh with that. That they had their homework done, I suppose, on how to get across the blanket defence, as you call it. But it's not so much the blanket defence, and people think that we build our games on a blanket defence. It's not really that. You know what I mean? It's counter-attack as well. And we did counter, we didn't take our opportunities. And I think, you know, rather than, I thought our defence coped quite well in the first half. You know what I mean? Bar the last two scores, probably in the last 5 minutes before half-time, there was nothing really in it up until then. And the 3 points at half-time looked doable to us going in at half-time to turn it around.
But the scoring ratio for Cavan was simply not good enough to win a championship match. 2 points in the first half, and the Armagh, we knew, were going to stick with you in the second half. It simply wasn't good enough, the scoring ratio for Cavan today.
Well, that's true. You know, I can't argue with that. 9 points now in a championship match, it probably won't be more than most league matches either. So, you know, it's something, again, that we have to work on. And we have been working on it. But, you know, look, this is it. You have to kick the ball across the bar, and that's it.
Of course, they were here on their home ground in Armagh today, and they were very anxious to win this game, and they changed tactics, as their manager said, from last year. They went out to win this game, and it showed in the second half. They really were determined to put you away.
Well, I'm sure they went out to win it last year as well. I'm not too sure if that statement stacks up either. But anyway, you know what I mean? I suppose in different days you can make different statements. Every time you go to play a championship match, you're going to win it. And I've never hid behind the fact that you go to win it. The stage are not good enough, and you're not good enough, you have to hold your hand up and be honest about it. You don't put it around and say that, you know, we went out to be totally defensive enough to win it. We went out to win the game, and we just wasn't good enough on the day.
And finally, Terry, what is the most disappointing aspect as you and your team leave here, the park here in Armagh this evening?
Well, yeah, and of course, I suppose that again losing the game, the championship is all about winning, so you can't take anything from the game for us, and the fact that we've lost it. I don't see anything else, other aspect in it to take from it. It's all about the win.
Midfield, they were super at midfield for long periods, and their manager has recognised that in interviews there just after the game. It was a segment that Cavan were maybe hoping to do well in. Are you disappointed at that?
Yeah, so well, in fairness, Armagh won the midfield battle, and they won probably the midfield sector rather than just a pair of midfielders. It was more than just the two guys in the middle of the field. I think their half-backs, half-forwards won a lot of the breaking ball as well. And, you know, that is where the game, the axis of the game was turned on. So you can go from defence into attack winning the ball in those areas. We didn't win enough ball with them.
It's back to the drawing board for Cavan now and to the back door. Disappointing for Cavan after lots of strides last year, but I suppose you have to regroup.
Well, that's it. You know, when you go back, we're in the back door a little bit earlier than we would have expected to be, but that's it. We got a good run in last year. It's up to our lads to go back and get their heads right and prepare themselves to get a run in this year again.
Terry Hyland, thank you very much. Thank you.